So far, we learned that microgrids may become the solution to integrate large amounts of distributed renewable energy sources in future power systems. However, microgrids are not the only way to incorporate more distributed generation into the network. Today, we'll discuss about the virtual power plant. A virtual power plant is an alternative option to cope with the challenges introduced by distributed generation. However, a virtual power plant is significantly different from a microgrid. In this lesson, we're going to address the definition of a virtual power plant and the main differences that exist with respect to a microgrid. A virtual power plant, or VPP, can be defined as a cluster of distributed energy resources that is collectively operated by a central controller. A VPP can take the place of a conventional power plant while providing more flexibility. The definition given by the European project Citizen, which is part of the innovation platform Amsterdam Smart City, states that a virtual power plant is an online platform that aggregates people's production and consumption of solar energy and stores the surplus locally. Due to this aggregation, it is possible to trade energy on the wholesale markets. Many other definitions can be found, but in general, a virtual power plant is a cloud-based system that aims at integrating different energy sources and allowing them to work as a whole. Let's take a look at the main actors involved in a virtual power plant. In a virtual power plant, the sources are usually of different nature. Dispatchable sources, such as traditional power plants, may be present in the cluster, together with controllable and non-controllable distributed generators. Fuel cells and microturbines are examples of controllable distributed sources, whereas photovoltaic and wind energy are examples of non-controllable power sources. Backup generators and energy storage systems are usually included to ensure power supply in the system. The dispatch can be made with the help of forecasting schemes, usually performed one or a few days ahead. Flexibility in a virtual power plant can be enhanced by using load shedding and demand-side management techniques. The increase in the number of electrical vehicles and vehicle-to-grid technologies is opening the door for more possibilities in this regard. A virtual power plant can be controlled to satisfy peak loads and load fluctuations by the use of optimization techniques and control. Information and communication technologies and the Internet of Things play an important role in the aggregation of the capacities of several distributed generators. As aggregator, the virtual power plant acts as an intermediary between distributed resources and the wholesale electricity market. In this way, owners of PV panels can participate in the electricity trading market through the VPP. A virtual power plant can also provide ancillary services to both the distribution and the transmission system operators. In the next videos, you will learn in more detail what ancillary services are and what their use is in electrical power systems. But what are the most important differences between microgrids and virtual power plants? First of all, a key factor is locality. In a microgrid, energy resources are located within the same local distribution network, and they aim to satisfy primarily the local demand. In a VPP, distributed generators are not necessarily placed in the same local network, and they are coordinated over a wider geographical area. The VPP aggregated production participates in traditional trading in normal energy markets. A second factor to take into account is size. The installed capacity of a microgrid is typically quite small, going from a few kilowatts to several megawatts. A VPP instead can have much higher power rating. A third important aspect is customer involvement. In a microgrid, the focus is on satisfaction of local consumption. Virtual power plants, on the other hand, consider consumption as a flexible resource that can be traded in the energy market. So to summarize, in this video we have seen what a virtual power plant is and what type of generators and loads are usually controlled to enhance flexibility and satisfy demand. Then we saw how to differentiate the concept of virtual power plant from the concept of microgrid. In fact, virtual power plants tend to aggregate distributed generation over a wider geographical area. They typically have a higher installed capacity compared to a microgrid. Finally, virtual power plants tend to consider consumption as a source of flexibility, whereas The aim of microgrids is to meet the local load required.